Hi guys, this is editorial analysis for 2nd October 2016. Let's go to the first one. This is from the Hindu newspaper. It talks about what a hyperplastic bone is. So it is used for reconstructive surgery. It can be implanted under the skin as a scaffold for the bone to grow on or as a replacement for the bone. It is synthetic in nature. So that's what a hyperplastic bone is. It could come in preliminary. Let's go to the second editorial. This is also from the Hindu. It talks about a new initiative called MAA. Its full form is Mother's Absolute Affection. This was undertaken on the recommendation of WHO and UNICEF. It emphasizes on early initiation of breastfeeding, that is, in the first hour of life of the baby. And it says that for the first 6 months, the baby should be only breastfed, no other solid or liquid food, and then continued breastfeeding from 6 to 24 months along with supplementary food. This MA program will train nurses, ASHAs and ANMs, that is auxiliary nurses, midwives. There's one more move that we have taken for the child's benefit, and that is Maternity Benefit Act of 1961. So these are some of the measures that our country has taken to curb the infant mortality rate. So let's move on to the third editorial. This is from the Indian Express. It talks about the problems of Swachh Bharat Mission. The first problem is that the goal of elimination of open defecation is 2019 under Swachh Bharat Mission. But a recent report by the Ministry of Drinking Water and Sanitation called Swachh Sarvekshan Report, it reports of latrine construction and use. It is widely believed that the methodology used in it is not credible, since most people won't admit it openly that they practice open defecation. Secondly, between 2014 to 2017, allocations to Swachh Bharat Mission trebled, that is, increased three times. All this is going only for latrine construction and none is going into information, education and communication. Thirdly, Indian government promotes manual pit emptying latrine. That is, and people don't want that kind of latrine anymore. That requires manual cleaning of the latrine pits. Also, it's very degrading to Dalits because traditionally it's the Dalits of India who have to, they are seen as the ones who have to clean it. Fourthly, another survey suggests that most people don't know that the elimination of open defecation is an important part of Swachh Bharat Mission. They only associate Swachh Bharat Mission with general household cleanliness and garbage cleaning. So this is a critique of Swachh Bharat Mission. Let's go to the next editorial that was there in the papers yesterday, and I had said that I'll cover it today. This is on a very, very important topic of financial inclusion in India, and it's a very important topic in GS paper 3 of mains, and almost invariably every second year you will find a question on this. So the author here points out certain problems in financial inclusion of this country. Firstly, that one-fourth of our population is illiterate and below poverty line. Rural poverty is especially higher in the Bimaru states, Orissa, Jharkhand, Chhattisgarh, Manipur, etc. This poverty is due to low farm income, lack of sustainable livelihoods and lack of skills, underemployment and unemployment. Secondly, the second problem is that banks try to overcome this problem of illiteracy among people by ensuring biometric access to bank accounts. What is biometric access? That is use of iris scan or thumbprint, etc. That is unique to each individual. So you know Aadhaar uses these biometric indicators. However, using Aadhaar card to do this still means that some numbers have to be punched in the machine to operate an account. That means, and also all the numerals in the machine are in English. So that means what it implies is that only the banks or the banking correspondents can punch in these numbers. Also, after one has operated his or her account, the messages sent from the bank to the mobiles of the customer, they are also in English. So this causes a lot of distress to the customer, because then he or she, they have to seek other people's help to read it. It also breaches their privacy. Some banking correspondents are acting extra smart. What they're doing is that in order to make it easy for themselves, what they're doing is that they give the same PIN number to an entire village. And it can cause devastating results for schemes like direct benefit transfer if it was to be implemented on a larger scale. The third problem is that unlike salaried groups, most other people in India are employed in informal sector. And they have uncertain seasonal and unplanned incomes. That means their income is too less to put it in a PMJDY account, Pradhan Mantri Jan Dhan Yojana account. So what are some of the solutions, measures that we can take to deal with these problems? So the author says that public sector banks opened 24 crore Pradhan Mantri Jan Dhan Yojana accounts in a record time. But what this move did was that it diverted their attention from their principal activity of mobilizing resources and lending to reliable borrowers. Of course, you know, that is the main function of the bank, that is to accept deposits and make out loans. So, and this they did in spite of the lack of good quality infrastructure and manpower. So the author, he suggests that move some of the new PMJDY accounts to rural and urban cooperatives, since public sector banks have already done their share of heavy weightlifting. Secondly, the author suggests that RBI, there are too many institutions in this country which act as a regulators or which act as a regulator of financial inclusion. There is RBI, there is NABARD, SEBI, SIDBI, Mudra Bank and all. So the author says that we need to fix, we need to find one regulatory body and we need to fix the responsibility of ensuring financial inclusion on that one regulator which will be responsible for ensuring that Jan Dhan Yojana accounts are functional. The author thinks that NABARD is the best candidate for this because of its extensive presence in the country. Thirdly, the author says that money lenders still make 30% of the total banking business in this country despite the high rates of interest on which they offer loans. And this is because of ease of doing business with them. So what is it that makes people go to money lenders instead of a bank, which even though the bank is offering loans at a much lower rate? So we must do some extensive studies, we must do surveys, and we must find out why these people are going to money lenders, private money lenders, and not banks. So we need a lot of detailed and extensive research in that field. So the author suggests these three measures. So that's it for today. Thank you.